In this part, we will take up one of the plastids, that is chloroplast. Chloroplasts are the green plastids or the green pigment containing plastids. These chloroplasts, they were discovered by Anton von Leeuwenhoek. But the term chloroplast was given by Skimper. We will first take up the different shapes and the numbers of chloroplast which are found in different types of cells, and then we will take up the detailed structure. If we are talking about the number of chloroplast per cell, number of chloroplast per cell, it can be one per cell, one chloroplast per cell. And the example or the cells where we find only one chloroplast in a cell is Chlamydomonas, Eulothrix. These are green algae in which in every cell there is only one chloroplast. Another is the number may vary from 1 to 16 per cell, and this is in Spirogyra. Spirogyra is again a green filamentous alga. Number of chloroplast varies from 20 to 40 per cell in higher plants. And 500 chloroplast per cell have been reported in Kara. And the cell in which this number was found was internodal cell. In internodal cell of Kara, 500 chloroplast per cell have been reported. So the number of chloroplast per cell is variable. Now when we talk about the shape of chloroplast, shape is also variable. We'll take some shapes which are important. One is called cup shape or horseshoe shape. This is found in Chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas is a green alga and the shape is like a water drop. So if this is the Chlamydomonas, it is a biflagellate green alga, and it has only one chloroplast. The chloroplast is large and it is cup shaped. So the shape of chloroplast is like this. This is the green pigment containing chloroplast. And this shape is written as cup shape or sometimes also known as horseshoe shape. The second is called girdle shape. Girdle shaped chloroplast. And we find it in the cells of Eulothrix. Eulothrix is unicellular, but all the cells are attached to each other and we find a filament like structure. So when we draw Eulothrix, there is a lower cell which is normally attached to the substrata. This cell is called holdfast, and this holdfast is without chloroplast. But above it there are these cells, and each cell is going to have one chloroplast. When we were writing about the number, we said in Chlamydomonas and Eulothrix, only one chloroplast is present in a cell. So in this structure, every cell has only one chloroplast. So if we enlarge one cell of Eulothrix, we find a girdle shape. Girdle is like C-shaped structure. So we find a girdle-shaped chloroplast. This is the girdle shape. The nucleus is inside. So we are drawing it like this, but if you turn it, the nucleus is somewhere in the middle, but when we draw it like this, we don't see the nucleus. So the shape is girdle-like, here the shape is cup-shaped. The third example for shape is ribbon-like, ribbon-shaped, and this is seen in Spirogyra. In Spirogyra, the cells are again arranged in the form of a long filament, and in each filament, suppose this is one cell that we are drawing, this is another cell. So in this, the chloroplast is flat ribbon-like. So here this is the chloroplast, it takes a turn, it comes here like a ribbon, it takes a turn, goes here, takes a turn. So this is the ribbon-like chloroplast. And there are the numbers which we have written here. The number is again from 1 to 16 chloroplast per cell. So ribbon shape in case of Spirogyra. In higher plants, that is the fourth one, in higher plants the shape is oval, or we call it discoidal. Discoidal shape. That means we normally draw the chloroplast like this. So this is the one which is seen in case of higher plants. So here example, higher plants. And because this is found, this is the shape which is found in higher plants, we study the structure which is the most common one in higher plants. So number is also variable and the shape is also variable. One more thing that we need to understand about chloroplast is that chloroplasts are dimorphic organelle. Dimorphic means they exist in two forms, and these two forms are granule and agranule. These two things we'll understand better after we are done with the structure of the chloroplast. So now let us talk about the structure, and this is the shape which we will be drawing. So let us draw the structure of chloroplast now. And as we said, we are going to draw the most common shape, that is the oval or discoidal shape, which is seen in case of the chloroplast of higher plants. It is a double membrane structure. The outer membrane is smooth. This is the outer membrane. It is smooth without any fold or anything. The inner membrane, it is also smooth. In case of mitochondria, inner membrane was thrown into folds which were called crista. Here, the inner membrane is also smooth. So this is the inner membrane. The outer membrane has less proteins and is permeable. Less proteins, and it is a permeable membrane. Whereas the inner membrane has more proteins and is selectively permeable. In many places, semi-permeable is also written. So it is either selectively or semi-permeable, which pretty much mean the same in this case. So there are two membranes. The inner space is filled with a material, a matrix, which is known as stroma. This stroma is rich in enzymes. These enzymes, which are required for the dark reaction. This is the organelle which is going to help in photosynthesis, and we know photosynthesis is completed in two parts. One is light reaction, the other is dark reaction. So dark reaction, it takes place in stroma, and so all the enzymes which are required, they are in the stroma. One such enzyme is Rubisco, ribulose biphosphate carboxylase. This is the most abundant protein in the world. Most abundant protein in the world. And that is present in the stroma of the chloroplast. This is the enzyme which actually helps in accepting the carbon dioxide in dark reaction. Now this stroma has some structures. We'll add those things little later after we have drawn those. The inner membrane of chloroplast shows invagination. These kind of infolds are there. And from these infolds, these membranous structures, they separate. So each structure, each sac-like structure is known as a thylakoid. And we can see many thylakoids are stacked over each another. So one such stack is known as a granum. So the lumen of thylakoid is actually connected with the inner membrane. Similarly, let us draw one more here. So this is again, the membranes are getting budded off and we find a stack. We will make a thylakoid separately, but these grana, they are connected with the inner membrane and many a times they are also connected with each other. So these membrane extensions, which are between the inner membrane and grana or between the grana, those are called stroma lamellae. Chloroplasts are also semi-autonomous. Semi-autonomous like mitochondria. And the reason is they have their own circular DNA and ribosomes. These ribosomes, they are called plastidoribosomes. And they are 70S type of ribosomes. And these are 70S type of ribosomes. So what all things are there in the stroma? There are enzymes. Stroma also has grana. It has circular DNA and 70S. Ribosomes. The stroma is rich in again divalent ions. So magnesium, manganese, and ferrous. These are the divalent ions which are present in the stroma also. So this is the structure. Now where is the chlorophyll? Chlorophyll pigment is, we are drawing it here, this in the thylakoid, there are these green pigment which are called chlorophyll. Though I am drawing it with red, this is chlorophyll. Because green is not very clearly visible on the board, that is why I am not using green here. But these pigments are green pigments and there, that is chlorophyll. Now let us come to this thylakoid. Each thylakoid is actually a sac-like structure. It is bound by the same kind of unit membrane. And if we want to make a couple of thylakoids or if we want to show the granum, then let us draw one more here. This is another thylakoid and its membrane. In the thylakoid membrane are present the pigments. Here it appears as if we have drawn the pigment in this middle, that is the lumen part. So this is called the lumen of thylakoid and this is the membrane of thylakoid. Chlorophyll pigments are present in the membrane. And these pigments are found in the form of quantosome. Quantosome is a unit or a collection of pigment which normally has 230 pigment molecules. These pigments include different types of chlorophylls. That means chlorophyll A, B, C, D, etc. It also it would include carotenoids, other pigments like xanthophylls and phycobilins. So all these pigments together make a unit which is called a quantosome, and the number of pigments in this unit would normally be 230. If we talk about the entire unit which is going to harvest light, we call it light harvesting complex. Light harvesting complex. And these complexes are written as photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Both contain a reaction center chlorophyll and accessory pigments which would gather the photons and pass it on to that reaction center chlorophyll. In PS1, that is photosystem 1, the pigment which is there absorbs 700 nanometer wavelength, whereas in PS2 it absorbs 680 nanometers of wavelength. Both are chlorophyll A. So the only difference is which particular wavelength is this chlorophyll absorbing. So coming back to this thylakoid, so when we are talking of these pigments, they are present in the membrane of thylakoids. These membranes, as we can see in the diagram, there are two parts. All around is the stroma. So there is a membrane part which is in contact with the stroma, and the membrane part which is not in contact with stroma, it is in contact with the membrane of other thylakoid. So the part which is in contact with each other, not in contact with stroma, are known as apprised part of the membrane. And the part of membrane which is in contact with the stroma is known as the non-apprised part. Now, when we are talking about this photosystem, PS2 is present here. PS2 is present in the apprised part, and PS1 is present in the non-apprised part. And the reason, because of this location, we have seen that in cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation, either both the photosystems participate or only one. That detail we have already discussed in the chapter of photosynthesis. So here we are talking only about the structural part. So in this diagram, when we make the entire organelle, it appears as if chlorophyll is inside the thylakoid. Or inside means the lumen part. But actually, the pigments are in the membrane of thylakoid. So this is the structure. Now we talked of chloroplast is a dimorphic organelle. Dimorphic means it exists in two forms. One was granule chloroplast, other one was a granule chloroplast. So granule chloroplast would have these grana, and a granule is without grana. That means it would have only stroma and few stroma lamellae. This granule has stroma and stroma lamellae, whereas the granule ones have grana and stroma both, plus the stroma lamellae and stroma lamellae. So these are the basic two types of chloroplasts. Now, where are these two found? Granule chloroplasts are found in the mesophyll cells of C3 and C4 plants. Whereas A granule ones are found in the bundle sheath cells of C4 plants. Again, The details of this we have discussed in the chapter of photosynthesis. So this is the structure. Now if we have to write down the function of chloroplast, it performs one function, that is photosynthesis. So function of chloroplast is one, photosynthesis. Function is photosynthesis. Light reaction takes place in thylakoid and dark reaction takes place in stroma part. So where we have written thylakoid, we will write down it is the site for light reaction, and stroma we have already written that it has enzymes for dark reaction. So it is the site for dark reaction. One more function which is assigned to chloroplast is because of this DNA. It helps in cytoplasmic inheritance. Cytoplasmic inheritance. So this is how the structure of chloroplast is. This is the most common shape which is found in higher plants, the thylakoids, and we now know the location of chlorophyll where light reaction takes place, and stroma where the enzymes for dark reaction are present. So we can divide the class function as light reaction in thylakoid, dark reaction in stroma, or photosynthesis as a whole, the function of chloroplast.